Hello everyone, in this session we'll look some problems on gear trains. Let us go with the first problem. In a reverted epicyclic gear, the arm A carries gear B and a compound gear DE. The gear B meshes with gear E and gear C meshes with gear D. The number of teeth on gears B, C and D are 75, 30 and 90 respectively. Find the speed and direction of gear C when the gear B is fixed and the arm makes 100 rpm clockwise. So in this type of problem, they won't give the drawing. From the sentence, we have to make the drawing. So first let us go through the sentence. First, the arm A carries gear B and compound gear DE. So now let us consider this. This is arm A. This arm A carries one gear named gear B and another compound gear DE. So this is E and this is D. So DE, either D may be here or here. We have to go to the next sentence. The gear B meshes with gear E. So since this is gear B, this is meshing with gear E. So therefore this must be gear E. So gear B meshes with gear E and gear C meshes with gear D. So another gear C is here. So this is meshing with gear D. Since this is reverted gear train, the axis of these two gears and these two gears must be aligned together. So this is a compound gear, this is a reverted gear. So now these two will be in mesh, these two will be in mesh, and this axis are aligned together. This is an arm. Okay, so now we'll have a schematic sketch for this one. So schematic sketch. Gear B meshing with gear DE, compound gear, and arm A is connected with this. This is arm A, and gear C is meshing with gear D. So gear C here is back side of this gear. Gear C is meshing with gear D. So this is the configuration of the gear. Now we'll go to the problem. What is given here? Number of teeth of B is given, 75 teeth. Number of teeth on C is 30, number of teeth on D is 90, and they have given gear B is fixed and arm makes 100 rpm clockwise. So therefore speed of gear B equal to 0, NB equal to 0, and speed of arm is 100 rpm clockwise. So therefore A is arm here, NA equal to minus 100. Since we assume that anticlockwise is in plus, clockwise is obviously minus. So NA equal to minus 100 clockwise. Now to solve the problem, we have to make the same tabulation, conditions of motion and speeds of the gears. First we have to assume that arm A is fixed and give one revolutions to compound gear DE. So now assume this arm A is fixed and give one revolutions to the compound gear DE anticlockwise. So arm A 0, compound gear DE plus 1. Since this is one revolution, anticlockwise plus 1. We know that in compound gear, both the gears will run in the same speed. So therefore speed of gear E equal to speed of gear D. So ND equal to NE. Now gear B is meshing with gear E. So we have to determine the gear ratio for B and E. So NB by NE equal to TE by DB, obviously. So we know that NE equal to 1. So therefore NB equal to TE by DB. So since this is rotating anticlockwise, this will be rotating clockwise. So therefore sign changes. So this will be minus. Now again come to gear C. Gear C is meshing with gear D. So therefore NC by ND equal to TD by TC. Since ND is also equal to 1, we are assuming that rotating 1 rpm clockwise for compound gear D and E. So therefore both ND and NE equal to 1. So therefore ND equal to 1 here. Substituting ND equal to 1 here, NC equal to minus TD by TC. So now this is about gear ratio. Now second step is we have to add x revolution to the same. Instead of one revolution, we have to add x revolution to all elements. So 0 here plus x minus x into TE by TB minus x into TD by TC. Add y to all. So total motion is y, x plus y, y minus x into TE by TB, y minus x into TD by TC. So these algebraic expression are the speed of compound gear DE, gear B and gear C. Now what is asked to determine? We have to determine the speed and direction of gear C when gear B is fixed and arm makes 100 rpm clockwise. So we need to determine the speed of gear C. That we have to determine this one. So we have to calculate this one, y minus x into td by tc. Our condition is given speeds of all the teeth, and we need to determine y minus x into td by tc. We have td and tc. We need to determine x and y. Here the condition is gear B is fixed. So therefore y minus x into te by tb equal to 0. Okay. So to determine this, we need the value of te. So for that, we have to use the configuration of this sketch. So we know that from this configuration, dc by 2 or radius of c, these two centers are same. So for both b and c, center is same. And for gear D and E, center is same. So therefore, obviously radius of C and radius of D, radius of C here to radius of D, that will be equal to radius of B and radius of E. So therefore, DC by 2 plus DD by 2 equal to DB by 2 plus DE by 2. So just by removing by 2 on all the places, DC plus DD equal to DB plus DE. So replacing diameter with number of teeth, we'll be getting TC plus TD equal to TB plus TE. So except TE, we have number of teeth known for all other gears. So therefore, from these values, we can find number of teeth on E, gear E, TE as 45. So from this, if you substitute the value over here, we can determine X and Y values. Okay, so NB equal to Y minus X into TE by T equal to 0, and arm is rotating at speed of 100 rpm clockwise. So therefore NA equal to Y. So Y equal to minus 100. So substituting Y equal to minus 100 and TE and TE value, TE and TB value over here, we can determine the value of X. So X equal to minus 166.67. So substituting X and Y value over here and TD and TC, we can determine speed of gear C. So therefore NC equal to Y minus X into TD by TC. Substituting these values, we get plus 400. So plus 400 means this is running at 400 rpm clockwise. So therefore gear C is running at 400 rpm clockwise in this condition. This is about the first problem. We'll go to the second problem. So this is the second problem. In an epicyclic gear train, the internal wheels A and B and compound wheels C and D rotate independently about axis O. The wheels E and F rotates on pins fixed to the arm G. E gears with A and C, and F gears with B and D. All the wheels have same module and number of teeth, and number of teeth are TC equal to 28, TD equal to 26, TE equal to TF equal to 18. First, we have to determine the sketch the arrangement. Second, find the number of teeth on A and B. Third, if the arm G makes 100 rpm clockwise and A is fixed, find the speed of B. Fourth, if arm G makes 100 rpm and wheel A makes 10 rpm counterclockwise, find the speed of gear B. So this is about the problem. Here also, they won't give the drawing. We have to determine the drawing. We have to draw it based on the questions given. Okay, so here they have given there are two internal wheels A and B. So let us go with the two internal wheels A and B, and one compound wheel C and D rotates independently about axis O. Then therefore gear A, gear B, compound gear C, D all are about same center. So A, B, C and D all are on the same center. Now come to the condition. So there is an arm G. So there are wheels E and F rotates on pins fixed to the arm G. There is arm G somewhere here. Okay. So this is arm G. Now E gears with A and C. So now A is here, C is this outermost gear, A is this outermost gear. So therefore if I draw a gear that will be meshing with gear A and C, so that will be gear E. Similarly, F gears with B and D. So this inner gear, inner internal wheel is B and this one is D. So another gear F is mating with gear D and B like this. So this is gear F. This is about the configuration of the epicyclic gear train. So from this we have to determine remaining data. So now given number of teeth on C is 28, D is 26, and number of teeth on E and F are 18 each. Okay. So now this configuration can be drawn like this. So initially we can determine remaining number of teeth. We know only number of teeth on C, D, E and F. We want to have number of teeth on A and B also to solve the problem. So now we have this configuration. From this configuration, we know that this is diameter of A, full length. So now here this is diameter of E, this is diameter of C and this is diameter of E. So to have number of teeth on A, that will be summation of 2 times E and 1 times C. So therefore DA will be equal to DC plus 2 times DE. Similarly DB will be equal to DD plus 2 times DF. So from this concept, if we replace diameter with number of teeth, TA will be equal to TC plus 2 TE, TB will be equal to TD plus 2 TF. Substituting these values over here, we can find number of teeth on A as 64, number of teeth on B as 62. Now these data can be used to solve the problem. Now here the condition is, we have to determine the number of teeth on A and B, we have determined here. And the condition is, if arm G makes 100 rpm clockwise, then we have to fix arm G, speed of G equal to minus 100, and A is fixed, then speed of A equal to 0, we need to determine the speed of B, first condition. Second, the same arm G makes 100 rpm and wheel A makes 10 rpm counterclockwise. So here first condition A is fixed, in the second condition A makes 10 rpm counterclockwise or plus 10 rpm, then we need to determine the speed of gear B. Now we can put the same tabulation. First condition, arm G is fixed, give one revolution to compound gear CD. We can assume the central gear. From the central gear we can go back, go to the subsequent meshing gears. So central one is compound gear. So arm G is fixed, give plus one revolution to compound gear CD. So therefore ND equal to NC. Since it is a compound gear, speed of C will be equal to speed of D. So therefore compound gear having plus one RPM here. Now this C gear is meshing with E, so immediately we can put gear E. So since these are external gears, if this is plus then this is minus. Now if we determine gear ratio here, NE by NC equal to TC by TE. Since we know NC equal to 1, substituting NC equal to 1 here, we can determine NE as minus TC by TE. Since this is the direction changes, here minus comes, so NE equal to minus TC by TE. Now come to gear A. Gear A is meshing with gear E again. So this gear A is meshing with gear E. So therefore to determine the gear ratio, NA by NE equal to TE by TA. Now this is also minus. Why? Because this is external gear, this is internal gear. Both will rotate in the same direction. So same direction represents the same sign. Minus here, here also minus. So NA equal to NE into TE by TA. Substituting the value of NE here, we get TC by TA, minus TC by TA. This is not the algebraic multiplication. Here minus and minus will not come plus. If this is direction of rotation is clockwise, this is also clockwise. So both should be in minus sign only. Now come to gear F. Gear F is meeting with gear D, the compound gear D. So therefore NF by ND equal to TD by TF. Since ND equal to 1, compound gear speed is 1. Initially we assume that compound gear speed is 1, ND equal to 1 here. So substituting ND equal to 1 here, we get NF equal to minus TD by TF. Since this is rotating in anticlockwise, this is in clockwise. So therefore plus here and minus here. Now comes to gear B. Gear B is an internal gear meshing with gear F. So same sign comes. So since this external gear is meshing with internal gear, the sign will be same. So substituting here, determining the gear ratio, NB by NF equal to TF by TB. Substituting NF value over here, we get NA equal to TD by TB. So minus sign here, here minus sign, same direction of rotation. So here also minus sign. So minus TD by TB. Second step is same thing, give X revolution to all elements, 0 plus X minus X into TC by TE, minus X into TC by TA, minus X into TD by TF, minus X into TD by TB, and add Y to all elements and total motion, Y, X plus Y, Y minus X into TC by TE, Y minus X into TC by TA, Y minus X into TD by TF, Y minus X into TD by TB. So this represents, this algebraic expression represents speed of those gears. Speed of compound gear is X plus Y, speed of gear E is this value, like that. Everything represents speed of those gears. Now we need to determine the speed of gear B with two conditions. The first condition is if arm G makes 100 rpm clockwise and A is fixed. So arm G is Y. So if Y equal to minus 100, clockwise represents minus sign. So Y equal to minus 100 and gear A is fixed. So this one, Y minus X into TC by TA equal to 0. Then we need to determine value of X and Y. Okay. So substituting Y value here, we have all the number of teeth already determined. So TC, number of teeth on C is 28 and number of teeth on A is 28. So minus 100 minus X into 28 by 64 gives X value minus 228.57. Substituting Y value and X value over here, we need to determine the speed of gear B. So NB equal to Y minus X into TD by TB. So Y minus X into TD by TB gives us minus 100 minus substituting X value and Y value here, we get minus 4.14 clockwise. Means speed of the gear is rotating at 4.14 rpm clockwise. The minus sign represents clockwise direction. The second condition is if arm G makes 100 rpm and wheel A makes 10 rpm counterclockwise, then find the speed of the gear B. The same condition, arm equal to minus 100 rpm clockwise, and the same condition here, instead of 0 it is rotating at 10 rpm counterclockwise, so plus 10. Y minus X into TC by TA equal to 10. So substituting these values over here, we get X equal to 251.42 and Y equal to minus 100. So substituting in this equation, Y minus X into TD by TB, Y is minus 100, X is 251.42, and substituting number of teeth on D and B as 26 and 62 here, we get plus 5.43 counterclockwise. That means speed of gear B is, if we are rotating wheel A 10 rpm counterclockwise, then speed of the gear B will be equal to 5.43 rpm counterclockwise. So this is about the determination of speeds of gear B from the given condition. Okay, this is about the second problem. Okay, if you have any doubts, you can put on comments. Thank you. If you like this video, you can subscribe, like and comment. Thank you.